Doc, do you think Ben Simmons can still be a point guard for a championship team like the one you guys want to become?
Yeah, David, I don't know that question or the answer to that right now. So I don't know the answer to that.
Guangdong Tigers. Ni hao! Ni hao! Ni hao!
Sixers were touted as one of the contenders coming out the East, especially when they secured the number one spot over the whole Eastern Conference. Now, in my opinion, I didn't think the Sixers were going to make the finals at all, but I damn sure didn't think they was going to lose to the Atlanta Hawks. No diss to the Atlanta Hawks. I know y'all good. I know y'all got Trae Young, but to be honest, I know Trae Young is good, but I did not know Trae Young was this good, especially towards winning basketball. You had an MVP candidate with Joel Embiid. You had an all-star level player with Ben Simmons. You had a 20-point per game scorer who's efficient, Tobias Harris. You have Seth Curry, a knockdown shooter at a good price. You have great depth with Matisse Thybulle, with Dwight Howard. You have a veteran head coach with Doc Rivers. You have a great home crowd with Real Fargo Center. You have everything towards your way, and y'all still lose the game, and that is not okay. Ben Simmons needs therapy, bro. He needs to talk to a sports psychologist, somebody to get him out his head, because at this point, it's just sad, bro. And I've been on this channel either slandering Ben Simmons for not scoring enough or giving Ben Simmons praise for doing everything else, like passing, like defending, like running in transition. It's a thing with Ben Simmons, but this game, he was doing neither of those. Even then, that passing ability is voided because I don't think he's confident even passing the ball. The only thing that Ben Simmons does is lob entry passes to Joel Embiid and get the fuck out the way. He doesn't do anything on that end to make me proud of him, ever. I'm gonna show you this picture right here, bro. You got Danilo Gallinari behind Ben Simmons, and you got who as the help defender for a point blank dunk? Not a layup, a dunk. You got Trae Young. Trae Young is considered to be one of the worst defenders in the league, and damn sure can't jump with somebody who's 9 inches, 100 pounds stronger than him. So what does Ben Simmons do? I'm gonna let y'all decide. No, he didn't finish just like a regular human being. He passed the ball. This man passed an open layup up, and Trae Young didn't even contest the shot. He was gonna pass it before Trae Young even thought about contesting it. That's making me think that this man mental is out of the loop. And y'all know me, bro, I care about mental health. If Ben Simmons is really going through mental problems, a mental block, a mental hurdle he can't really get through, I won't bash him like that. But this is bad, bro. This is bad. At the end of the day, bro, this is basketball. You've been playing this sport since you was 4 years old. You're getting paid at least $25 million a year to do this sport, and you can't finish a dollar layup, a dollar shot layup. And look at Joel Embiid's reaction to it. Joel Embiid knows that this is some BS. My second best player, the guy who's big as me, will not finish a layup. I got to do everything on offense, even though I'm playing on one leg. And it would be better for me to feel bad for Ben Simmons if he didn't talk trash during the game. Now, there's nothing wrong with talking trash. I actually love trash talking during basketball. It brings the competitive spirit out. But you can't trash talk before and after the whistle. But during the game, you want to be so passive and so scared that you have everybody in Philadelphia wanting to arrest you on the spot. You can't do that. Pick a side. Pick a struggle. I was waiting the whole series for Ben Simmons to play good, or just to have that one breakout game, because at the end of the day, bro, we know Ben Simmons is so easy to bully. He's so easy to slander, but at the end of the day, he is a max level player. He is an all-star in the Eastern Conference. So I was waiting for that all-star to pop out. You know what I'm saying? 20, 10, and 10. That's all I really needed for one game. But we really couldn't get that. That's how you know it was mental, bro. It really is mental. I don't know what these players go through, bro, on a day-to-day basis during the playoffs. I don't know if they read comments, watch Twitter, Instagram, because if you actually do, I would get how you can play horrible, because them little kids be some bullies, bro. They be some little bullies, bro. And I'm not trying to even slander Ben Simmons, but I'm disappointed, bro. It's embarrassing. And I love the underdog story with Trae Young. Props to them. I'm making a video tomorrow of Trae Young, so I don't want this negative energy to be my whole channel. I don't want to just slander players when they play bad. I also want to give props when players play good. I have to talk about this, and I made about 4 videos this playoffs talking about Ben Simmons, and everybody keeps saying he does this, he does that. Well, it's not enough. It's not enough. You a big ass Jason Kidd. Even worse than Jason Kidd. Jason Kidd attacked the rim. Don't matter what his stats was. You have to trade Ben Simmons. Now, I don't know what a Ben Simmons trade looked like. A, he makes a lot of damn money. B, he has a certain skill set that only works for a certain team. Now, I don't know if Ben Simmons is the main instructor of a team, maybe a bad team at this point, but I don't know if he can be a good second option, because I think every second option in the league needs to be able to score. He's a good third option, and that's a fall from grace, bro. We was comparing Ben Simmons to Magic Johnson his first year, and it was rightfully right. It was right to compare him to Magic Johnson. Look at the stats. Now, 4 years later, 5 years later, he's doing worse with the same stats. I could give a damn about them assist numbers. I could give a damn about them rebound numbers, bro. I could give a damn about your VORP, your analytics, bro. If you can't get it cracking when you need to get it cracking, which is the playoffs, you are voided to me. And you're wasting Joel Embiid's prime, bro. Doc Rivers. I don't know why they hired Doc Rivers, especially when you know the history of the Sixers in the playoffs. You combine a choking team with a choking coach. One thing about Doc Rivers is he gonna make you play every game like it's your last, because every game gonna be close. No lead will be safe. Don't matter where you at, he will lose at home. He will lose up 30. He will lose when three of their best players are out. He will do everything. He will make every series competitive. And I fuck with you, Doc Rivers, for that, because you make some great basketball content for rigging the games. But as a team, you should be fired as well. I don't know what the Sixers are doing. Now, the only player I think that should be traded on the Sixers is Ben Simmons. I think that was his last game as a Sixer. And they need to do, I don't know what they should do. Tobias Harris played bad. He was 24 points, 8 for 24 from the field, but it's a game 7. I get that. Everybody gonna play bad in the game 7. You know what I'm saying? I think they need a point guard, man. I feel like we need a point guard. Not we. I'm not no Sixer fan. But I feel like they need a point guard. Or somebody who can manipulate the defense a little bit. Somebody who can keep the defense honest instead of doing lob entry passes and then getting doubled. Joel Embiid gets doubled every play, man. They need to get a PG. I will throw the truck at any point guard who can manipulate the defense. Maybe they should think about getting Kemba Walker, even though Kemba Walker is also a playoff choker. It's really nobody they can really get, because I don't really trust small guards in the playoffs. Only if you're on that superstardom role like Trae Young, like Chris Paul. I really think the Sixers are cooked. I don't know what they can do to improve their team so drastically where nobody is going to give up on them next season. You know what I'm saying? This NBA is different. If your point guard can't create for himself, if your point guard can't be a threat on offense, I don't care how big he is, I don't care how skillful he is in the paint, I don't care if he has the best defense in human history, if he can't create for himself, he is a liability in the playoffs. And it's not like the Hawks had a great defense. The Hawks' best defender on the court was, I don't know, Danilo Gallinari. Who was the best Hawks defender? Ben Simmons, bro. Trae Young, Kevin Huerter, John Collins, Clint Capela, Bogdanovich, Gallinari. Why can't you score on either of these players? Why? And this is gonna happen anyway, because it was gonna get even worse next round. Joel Embiid, bro, you did what you had to do, man. You proved yourself time in and time out that you are a player in the playoffs, bro. You don't give up. You are playing on one leg, shooting step back threes, ups, dunks, playing defense. You're doing everything that you possibly can. You willed your team to almost win it, but your teammates let you down. Your teammates let you down. Now, I don't know if Seth Curry's contract situation, but they should sign Seth Curry to a bigger contract. He deserves way more money, way more playing time, way more freedom, because Seth Curry was better than Ben Simmons in this series. Seth Curry was the second best player in this Sixer playoff run. It was doomed from the start, bro. It was doomed from the start. But that'd be all for this video, bro. Make sure you subscribe and like. Daily videos coming at you, man. Keep your mind up. Keep yourself right spiritually. Keep yourself right mentally. Keep yourself right physically. And I'm out, man. Peace.